Okay, this is a continuation of the previous video. We're going to be solving more quadratic equations by using square roots. And in this case, it's going to be in this format, a times x plus b squared equals c. So the idea is pretty much the same. It's almost like solving equations, right? Where we're trying to basically isolate the variable. Because that's the general idea here. So first things first, we want to get rid of all the stuff on the exterior first. So we're going to divide both sides by 2 in order to do that. So let's divide this side by 2. I shouldn't do the whole thing by 2, and that by 2 as well. And we're going to get to, what is this, x minus 9 squared equals 64, right? And now we get to deal with this exponent here. And the way we deal with it is we're going to, again, take the square root of both sides, and you end up with x minus 9 equals plus or minus 8, because that happens to be the solution of the square root of 64. Now, something interesting happens here that I do want to draw your attention to. You have two roots, which means our answer is going to branch off into two different directions, right? We're going to have one answer where we have to deal with a positive 8, and we're going to have another answer where we deal with a negative 8 version. So it's almost like, you know, in those comic book movies when there are multiple dimensions. You have a dimension with a positive version of 8, and now you have to deal with a dimension with a negative version of 8. So if we go and deal with that, we're going to add 9 to both sides for this one. And we get x equals 17, and over here when we do that, we get x equals 1. So your answers are x equals 17 and 1. So for writing the answer here, it's 1 and 17. Okay, question number 2. So again, we're going to divide both sides by 4 first. 4 by 4. So we get x plus 10 squared equals 6. And then we're going to square root both sides, and we get x plus 10 equals plus or minus square root of 6. Okay, and so again, this is going to branch off into two different directions. We're going to get a x plus 10 equals square root of 6, and x plus 10 equals negative square root of 6. And then if we deal with this, subtract 10 from both sides, we get x equals negative 10 plus square root of 6. And on this side, we get x equals negative 10 minus square root of 6. So you could punch in the calculator and get an exact number, but we're going to leave it like that. We're going to leave it as negative 10 plus square root of 6 and negative 10 minus square root of 6. Okay. They do want the approximate solution. So if you were to punch in the calculator, let's see, for the plus square root of 6, you would get negative 7.55 according to the answer key, and negative 12.44.